Get the hell out of hell.
Our art department and the visual effects guys are so good. I mean, we give them a basic idea and they run with it, and it's generally better than anything that we could have imagined in the writer's room.
We're augmenting things that allowing the show to go in directions that typically it may not be able to go because of budget, because of time, because of safety, because it's just damn impossible. That's where we jump in.
Welcome to hell.
Hell varies of what it looks like. The first time I think we saw hell, Jensen was in chains and suspended, and it was very sort of vast, and you couldn't see much except him sort of screaming and lightning bolts and flashing on his face. Then, depending on what script we were working on, hell became, one time it was a sort of a mundane office building. The version of hell where we go and get Lucifer in the cage was something entirely different. So much of that was visual effects, because we had to create this world outside of what we were actually shooting.
The visual style for the supernatural hell was pretty much gothic. It was gothic and it was also infinity.
It was so much a product of the art department and the visual effects department. I think in episodes 9 and 10, they had more visual effects shots than we probably had the entire season before, just for those two episodes. What we were saying, can I shoot this way, can I shoot that way? And pretty much with Mark Millage, he'd go, yeah, you shoot any way you want, we'll take care of it.
We had pitched a lot of ideas when we were going through what we had to do. In this case, hell ended up being more void-like than anything else. Trying to get away from some of the Rocky Mountains, the flames, the usual what we typically imagine hell being like. So it was more storm-like and created its own kind of landscape.
We had a black box, a series of black curtains around our limbo set, the hell set. And our landscape was to continue off to infinity, but we didn't really have the money to kind of do a proper cove and fool the eye that way. So unfortunately, a lot of that fell to Mark, who had to basically go into every frame and, you know, paint in a little extension of the landscape, paint in lightning bursts and take out a light here, add a light there. So he had quite a job.
The fact that it went void-like actually helped us out, because then instead of creating entire virtual backlot that they had to be on, we basically filled in the gaps whenever we were off seeing things in the distance in order to be able to fill in everything that we needed to do in the time we had. The set itself is on a bit of a curve. What that allows us to do is, because we're doing a set extension, we'd be able to make the set look as long as we needed to look, but as they come around the corner, that would help us not having to fill in the back areas.
They would shoot, I go, okay, cut, and we go, okay, where'd we leave off? And then we take them back to the beginning of the hallway. So it looked like an endless hallway, which was only about maybe 100 feet.
I must say, it's not as scenic as I'd expected.
They did a lot. We kind of handed them, in some ways, a half-finished entity.
You know, to have them this big in, you know, on a big high shot, this was not my idea. This was something that Mark Millage said, you know, we can do this. And, you know, you go, all right, great. Just tell me how high you want to be when I'm shooting it. And you go, okay, well, that looks pretty cool unto itself, you know. And then they send you the animatic of what it's going to be, and you're just kind of blown away.
The height that he extended that to gave great energy and strength to, you know, this descension into hell. We didn't want to set any parameters on hell and keep it open enough to where people's imagination could fill in the blanks.
We sort of looked into other films, but also Hawaii, where you had these lava fields which stretch for what seems like miles, and they just seem to have consumed everything in their path.
We tried a number of different substrates, and then finally it became obvious that we are getting a cement mixer, we are putting black dye into cement, and we are going to pour this huge concrete slab where we can then place each skeleton to best represent the devastation of hell.
Am I up for parole?
When Lucifer appears, then the cage comes to life, and then we have to have actually light cues on the actors that approximate the flame. it's easy in my mind to say, all right, this is what I want to do. How they accomplish it is beyond my ken, you know. But those guys, they do that a lot, you know. What they did with the submarine is, you know, on a TV show. It's pretty amazing.
We want what's best for the show. So when we get a call, do you want to do a submarine or can we do a submarine? We go, heck yeah, let's do it.
Doing a submarine is not easy. It's a lot of involved detailing. It's not quite like an airplane. It's not quite like a train. It's not like a boat. It's sort of all three of those things.
You know, the guys did tremendous research on what a World War II submarine would look like. It feels very claustrophobic. Again, the attention to detail of where the sailors' bunks are, the torpedo room, all that is, you know, based on real photographs of real submarines from the period.
The submarine was 16 feet wide by 100 feet long, and the 16 feet wide is where we ran into a lot of logistical problems of shooting, because that's a very narrow set.
Each room had two or three different entrances or exits. You know, a sub, you only come in from the top. We had little hidden doors here, a panel would pull off here so you could light.
No matter how many gauges were on each wall, they were on a steel frame that had casters on it that they could pull back, so you had places to put the camera in so you could get the ability to shoot it.
We were gonna go above water, and creating water and creating fire a few seasons ago would have been beyond the scope of what we could do. But with software and hardware being what it is now, we can push things a little bit further. That was my goal. It's a little easier when there's a knife plunging in someone's chest or you've got someone smoking out, because a lot of that is hidden. This, there are no cheats. So it really went right down to the wire. But you know what, the way that everything kind of came together, I think it pulled nicely.
They never get over how good they are. And with no drama, you know, I mean, they just do it.
I think I'll look back on this experience, you know, maybe 5 years from now or 10 years from now and go, wow, it's pretty amazing what we've done here.
I mean, this show can bring me to tears, it can bring me to laughter, but most of the time I'm just excited.
That's actually the privilege of working in television, is to get a chance to work with all of these artists that come together to make the show exactly what it is.
The amount of production value we get because of these guys, it's really remarkable. I mean, they do so many sets, and they're amazing. They're just always great.